IQ. Okay, Northridge, Sarah Mejia. Sarah Mejia, Kiss Club VIP member of the day, up for grabs, log on the Ultimate SAG Awards package, the 42-inch plasma TV, a Grand SAGs TNT TBS. Tomorrow, you're working those.
I am the voice of the SAG Awards. We have rehearsals all day today.
What do you have to rehearse?
Well, it's live, so I have to do...
You've done about a million hours live.
I know. But they're comfortable if I'm there, and then I can announce, like, that some of the celebrities come today.
Do you know all the celebrity names? Because I don't when I'm on the red carpet.
There are some hard ones this year. The girl who stars in Precious.
I call her Gabby. I went through this already.
You did all that. See... Yeah.
You can't do that.
I had to. I was called back in for some revisions.
It's so funny because that girl, Gabby,
yeah,
who stars in Precious, her name's it is a tough one. And yeah, so what I do when in doubt, and if you ever watch these E! Shows and I just like go with a nickname, mm-hmm, that's because I can't pronounce her name.
Oh, then you'll be like that.
I think I got
Irritated. But watch it tomorrow because we're on TBS and TNT.
I think, that's great. You'll simulcast. I think I called Allison Irahita the wrong name for the whole season. She goes, you know,
Irahita, yeah.
But I would say Irahita or something like that.
That sounds right.
Yeah, Irahita. I thought she was Japanese. So she said to me, you're saying it like, you know, I'm from somewhere else. I'm like, look, Allison, darling, let's just stick with the consistency's key. So Adam Lambert is here. And by the way, Adam is doing this private show for us in New York, and I've got tickets for you to go if you want to sign up to be with Adam and his buddy Chris, and also Allison Irahita. You can go to RyanSeacrest.com. I got to play this right now. This is such a good record. It's on top of the charts. It is... We'll talk about it in a second. 102.7 Kiss FM, Adam Lambert.
Hey, slow it down. What do you want from me? What do you want from me? Yeah, I'm afraid. What do you want from me? What do you want from me?
That's Adam Lambert. What do you want from me? Now, who's that directed at, in theory?
In theory, I think it could be one of two things. It could either be the person you're in a relationship with and you're kind of confused about your emotional journey, or when I perform it sometimes, I kind of make it about the world, and I'm singing it to the world. What do you want from me, guys?
What do you think they want?
I'm trying to figure it out.
Next single! What do you guys want from me?
It's... Yeah, and especially with everything that went down, it was kind of like, I don't know what to do.
Yeah. It's a great song. I really love it, so congrats on that. Let's go to Monique West Covina. You're on with Adam Lambert. Go ahead.
Hi, Ryan. Hi, Alan.
How you doing?
Hi, Adam. I love you so much. You are awesome. I loved you on the AMAs. I loved you on Oprah. I loved you on The Fuse TV. I loved you on 2020. I have all my...
Oh, thank you. You're keeping up.
I love you.
Oh, thanks.
You are the best. You are just awesome. You're talented. You're amazing. You're handsome. You're sexy.
Stop it. We want to know when you're having a show in Los Angeles.
I don't know.
This is a concert. We need to have.
I know. We're working on it. I mean, it's something I definitely probably this year I'm going to be touring. Yeah, I don't know how or what, but it'll happen.
All right. Thanks for calling. We appreciate the love. Let's go to Jane, who's 12 in LA. Go ahead, Jane. You're on with Adam Lambert.
Hi, Adam.
Hi. How are you?
I'm doing good. You know what? I'm a really big fan of yours.
Thank you.
My mom is crazy about you. She's the number one biggest fan ever.
That's so cute.
Tell her I said thanks.
She's driving right now.
All right, tell her driving. Be careful. Thank you for listening. Question for you, going back to Oprah for a second. You guys talked about the paparazzi a little bit when you were on the show.
And yeah.
I thought I heard you say the word lonely at one point, and she kind of went on to the next question, but I was wondering, what was behind that statement?
Well, it was kind of separated from the paparazzi, just in general. Like, you know, it's funny, there's so much joy and excitement with this new lifestyle, but then sometimes it can feel a little isolated and lonely. Like, sometimes you're like, wow. You know, I have to, you know, because there's like paparazzi and people are, sometimes if you don't want to be on, you have to kind of like retreat and turn into a little recluse and just stay at home. You
right.
know what I mean? So,
but I understand that. But given the choice of like total privacy or having all that,
it's completely worth it.
This
is what I've always wanted. It's a dream come true.
It's like, you know, you know when you go for it, that's part of the gig, right?
Yeah, it comes with the territory, and it's, you know, I don't mean to complain. I'm just, you know, expressing sometimes it's lonely.
But you do know every delivery place that goes to your house, right? So when you hole up, you
know. Oh, yeah. I love my pink dot.
Yeah. but you know what you should do is at your place there, just about, I don't know, 6:37 sunset. Put your blinds up. Do a show for the paparazzi.
That's a good idea.
I love that.
Great
stuff.
Idea.
You were all about Harvey on that, all over TMZ. We're gonna come back with Adam. Don't miss AT40 this weekend with me.